Hi guys, it's me, Unique, and today I thought I'd show you how to properly prep a bag for going out in the world. I love this bag. It's got a unicorn on it and it's made of some kind of material that stays dry. I don't know what it is. Okay, when you're packing a bag to go out in the world, you need your favorite shades. You also need gum. Enough said. Now, you don't know if you're gonna have to write something when you're out in the world, so I recommend bringing a couple of pencils, preferably in your preferred color. Mine, of course, is purple. Chapstick, yes. And then you guys, also, tweezers. A must. I've seen long hairs coming out of my nose. Just saying. Oh, I forgot about this. You guys, I met these boys while I was on vacation and they're so cute. And one more thing, an onion. You're probably thinking to yourself, why, Unique? Why would you carry an onion? Well, maybe you might go to a friend's house and they might be cooking and they'd be like, oh no, this recipe calls for an onion and I don't have one. And you could be like, oh, I got you, girl. Here you go. So, right? Anyway, hope you enjoyed my unicorn bag tutorial. And remember, like and subscribe and donate, you guys. Okay? Bye.
First I was afraid, I was petrified, kept thinking I could never live without you by my side. But then I spent so many nights thinking how you'd done me wrong, and I grew strong. I learned how to carry on, take those shoes off, and so you're back.
You know what? While I was playing it, I noticed something over here. I think Mr. John left me some clues about our theme this week. Let me get rid of this guitar. Okay, let's see if I can figure out these beautifully drawn clues. See, the first one down here looks like a Target symbol to me. Maybe Mr. John wants to go to Target. I mean, who doesn't? I definitely want to go, but I'm not going. So that's a Target sign. What about this? Well, this looks like a checklist to me. I see a check mark here, and little boxes like you're checking off on a to-do list. I have such a love-hate relationship with to-do lists, let me tell you. And how about this one over here? Let's see. This looks like it might be a net. And I'm just gonna go ahead and assume that this is his representation of a soccer ball. I'm gonna give him the benefit of the doubt on that one. Maybe you should try drawing a soccer ball at home and see if you can do better than Mr. John. So let's see, there's a goal here, and I think this is a bullseye, and you're checking things off your checklist. It has to be goals. I think that the theme this week is goals, so let me write it down. Goals. G-O-A-L-S. Goals. And you know what? Today, I want to talk about goals that you set for just yourself, independent goals. And while we talk about them, let's build a tower. So independent goals are things that everyone gets to and has to do. They can be kind of tricky, but that's natural. Independent goals help you learn more about yourself, your likes and your dislikes, things that come easy to you, things that are more challenging to you. They help boost your creativity. They help boost your confidence when you reach them. So independent goals are important, and they can be small goals or big goals. You get to decide those for yourself. All right, couple more drums. And you have the last one, will you help me? Oh, beautiful, nice reach. All right, let's count these drums first. In English, will you count with me? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Now in Espanol, ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. En français. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Well, London Bridge is falling down. Falling down. My fair lady. While I clean these drums up, let me tell you about the two goals that I have for myself today during class. Let me grab the suitcase. My first goal is to be able to play the song called Chopsticks on our piano pad and to play it well without any mistakes. That's my first goal. And my second goal, let's see, is to practice balancing. I think what I'll do is I'll create a balanced course for myself and see if I can follow it one foot after the other without falling. That's a good one. Let's start with the first goal. I think that the piano pad is in the orange suitcase. Look, I don't really hear it, let's see. Is, oh my goodness, have you seen this before? This comes out rarely. Move that aside so I have tons of space. Let me open it up. Let's see what it looks like. Oh my goodness, it looks like a gigantic piano. It's got white keys and black keys, the sharps and the flats up here. Let me turn it on. It makes a little noise when you turn it on. Listen. My first goal was to play Chopsticks, and I'm gonna do that by jumping on the keys that need to be played. So let me center myself, get ready. Here we go. Oh my goodness, this sounds horrible. Honestly, I think it's on the wrong instrument. There we go. Okay, that sounds more like a piano. Okay, I'm gonna try one more time. I'm not really happy with how this is sounding, and you know what? I think I need to take a break from it right now. I just need to think about something else, move away from it. I tried, let's move on to some music and then we'll come back and try again. So let's see, this song is Miss Lily Original. Yep, I wrote this song. This song is about a little bird who's trying to learn how to fly. And I have a little bird here. Oh, she's really fuzzy. She's got some cool wings too. I love the way that she's got like spotted feathers on her wings. And I'm gonna hand her to you. Maybe you can fly her while we listen to the song, or you can dance along. Do whatever you like. All right. Here we go. Makes me feel nice and centered. I think I'm ready to do another shot at the piano pad. Oh, thanks, I'll take that bird. Adios, little bird. Okay. Are you cheering me on from home? Okay, here I go, I'm gonna give it a shot. Oh my goodness, what just happened? I don't know, let's do it again. Inspo for you tonight. Big. Does that make you think of the movie Big? It always makes me think of that movie. All right. Adios, piano pad. I'm just going to stick it back here because I want to get started with my next goal, which was to practice some balancing with my balance course. Now, in my blue suitcase today, I need a lot of space for this. I have something kind of magical. Let's see. Oh my goodness. It's a really soft and feathery pink feather boa. Oh, how beautiful. Oh, now it's hot pink. Let's see. Oh, now it's blue. Oh my goodness, this is the never-ending boa. Now it's purple. I see, wow. I think that's the longest boa I've ever seen. So with this boa, I'm gonna do something kind of cool. I'm gonna make a balance course. So that means I'm gonna lay my boa all through the carpet, and maybe I'll give myself some zigzags to walk through. Maybe, oh, that looks good. Maybe some curves, maybe a little more zigzag action over here. Oops, can I make it reach? I think I can. Great. Oh, okay, cool. So now I have one long loop of a balance course to walk on, just like this, one foot after the other. Do you want to try practicing walking one foot after the other with me at home? Let's do it. But of course, we need some music. I'm going to grab my ukulele. Okay, here we go. You put one foot in front of the other, and soon you'll be walking across the floor. One foot in front of the other, and soon you'll be walking out the door. You'll never get where you're going. Whatever works for you, but this is going to work that core, grown-ups. You're welcome. Adios. Step back in here. So we're going to start with our legs crisscross applesauce like this. I don't have a child. I'm just going to pretend that there's a little one on my lap, and we're going to start by bouncing. Well, a hip, a hip, a hippopotamus got on the city bus, and all the people said, give that little one a big squeeze. You're squishing me. Well, now a cow got on the bus. And all the people said, move over. Side to side, whoa. Well, now a sheep got on the bus. And all the people said, back it up. Woo! One more for good measure. Woo! And last animal, of course, a chicken. A chicken got on the bus. And all the people said, your feathers are tickling me. Tickle that little one. Awesome, very nice. We have time for one more song. I'm gonna grab my ukulele again, and let's move over to the guitar wall because it's so beautiful. This song is all about doing what makes you feel the most like you. If you've got bubbles at home, go ahead and bring them out, or maybe you'd like to just dance or listen along. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I can't wait to see you again next week. Bye.